Hello everybody and welcome back to the UNICAT channel. When you are planning to build an expedition vehicle, you're definitely asking the question, how big can it be and how maneuverable will it be? And then the next question is, so will it be a 4x4, will it be a 6x6 or even an 8x8? Now, the turning circle is one important issue in this, and this is something we want to explain to you today. We have prepared a couple of drawings for you, and we have shot videos to explain it better in reality. Now, the vehicle we took as a sample is the UNICAT TC78 Family Suite, which is a pretty long vehicle, but if you want to travel with 5 people, you need some space. So here on this drawing, you see a MAN crew cab with a wheelbase of 4,650 millimeters from front axle to first rear axle, and then another 1,400 millimeters to the third axle. And this is as the truck comes from the factory with steering in front, of course, but no steering in the back. So solid axles in the back. Now, how do we calculate the turning circle? We have to know the wheelbase and we have to know how much steering angle the truck provides at the front axle. So with the 1400 tires on the MAN TGS, you get approximately 33 degree maximum steering angle. Now, if you turn this wheel 33 degree and you make the line here, yeah, then you have one information. And if you have two solid axles in the back, you take the center and make a straight line here. And where the two lines meet, that's the center of your turning circle. And then you have to look where would the vehicle touch that circle, and that's here at the front. So if this is the center of our circle, and this is the point where we touch, then we put that circle, and then we arrive to a turning circle of 24.4 meters, which is quite a lot, but it's in the legal framework, which says the turning circle can't be more than 25 meters. So when it comes to larger vehicles with a long wheelbase like this one, the question is how good can it steer? And what is the turning circle of such a vehicle? Now we are showing you. Now we go without rear axle steering. So just the front axle is steering. And so we have a turning circle which is okay, but which is not great if you go off-road or if you go into small cities or small villages, small places in general. So the question is, how can we improve the turning circle? Now, the simple answer is either we make the vehicle smaller, or we make the wheelbase shorter, or we install a rear axle steering. Now, making the vehicle shorter is not an option in reality. And if you make the wheelbase shorter, then your weight distribution will be very bad. So we stick with the wheelbase, 4,650 millimeters plus 1,400 millimeters, but we add a steering axle. Now, what happens? When you do this, your steering angle in the front is still 33 degrees. So you get this line. But the only stiff and solid axle is your first rear axle, and that means we have a line here. And now we adjust the steering angle of the third axle so that it meets that same point where this line and this line are meeting. And then we do a circle again where the vehicle is touching, and then we get down to 21.8 meters. So from 24.4 down to 21.8. That makes a big difference. And not only that you have a smaller turning circle, this is much better for the surface because the rear axles are not rubbing, they are just following a proper circle one by one. So you don't destroy the grass, you do not harm the surface wherever you are driving in off-road. And it also is good for the tires, for the tire wear, because they are not rubbing, they are really rolling properly. And this is what we did on the TC78 family suite, which you see on this video. So now we do the same thing with rear axle steering. Let's say with normal rear axle steering. In a normal rear axle steering, the third axle has a steering, but the steering angle is just that much that it follows the path of the other wheels. So you're not destroying the surface because there is no rubbing at the end of the vehicle. And that's already much better. So the turning circle is getting smaller. And so the disadvantage of a big vehicle is quite compensated. Now you've seen that with the rear axle steering, we have gone from 24.4 meters turning circle, which is this circle out here, to 21.8 meters turning circle, which is this one here. But as you can see here, we can even do better. How can we do better? Very easy. If we oversteer the rear axle. So technically, the rear axle can go to a maximum of 20 degrees, which is actually not necessary to follow the path of the other tires, but we can go to 20 degrees. And if we do that, we actually force the truck into a smaller turn. And the calculation is, again, we have 30 degrees at the front axle. We have that line through the first rear axle, but then this one with more angle of steering, the center of this one will go here. So the real center of the turning circle is here, some in between. This depends a little bit on the traction of each tire, so this can only be calculated approximately, but this is very realistic because we have the proof of reality on our vehicles. Now, the turning circle is down to 19.4 meters, still with the same big unit, which has a MAN crew cab and a 7.8 meter body. I have pushed the button to activate the oversteering. We actually came up with that idea to minimize the turning circle. Now we steer the third axle to the maximum. This is not ideally on the line anymore. But if you have two solid rear axles without steering, they are also never on the ideal line. So now we do the opposite thing and make the truck turn even more and tighter. So now we have seen the turning circles of a truck without rear axle steering. We have seen the turning circle of a truck with rear axle steering in the normal setup. And we have seen the truck with rear axle steering in oversteering mode. But here we have another drawing, and this might be the most interesting drawing for you, because we are comparing a 6x6 with a 4x4. Here you see the same 6x6 we just talked about, 33 degree steering angle. This axle is solid, and this one steers actually with 11 degree to meet this point. So this is a normal rear axle steering, and we go to 21.8 meters turning circle. Now, if you say, well, but the 4x4 is more maneuverable, that's actually not true. Here we have made a similar vehicle, also with 4,650 millimeters wheelbase, but here we have a body length of 7.8 meters, and here we have a body length of 5.8 meters. And you can't do a 7.8 meter body on a 4x4. You get too much overhang, very bad angle of departure, and way too much weight on the rear axle. So the 4x4 is just limiting the body length quite a lot. But it does not affect the turning circle. Because again, we have 33 degree steering angle in the front, and we have one solid axle. And so if you put this line and if you put this line, you arrive to exactly the same turning circle that you can do with a 6x6. And not enough. If we look back to the oversteering, with the oversteering on the 6x6, we even get a much better turning circle than you can get with a 4x4 of the same wheelbase. And I think that's a very interesting information for everybody who is thinking about, well, shall I take a 4x4 or a 6x6? Of course, all this rear axle steering stuff is done on all-wheel drive vehicles. So it's not some extra two wheels in the back. We have always here a 6x6 vehicle. And actually, if we have a rear axle steering, we call it a 6x6x4, because we have six driven wheels and we have four steered wheels. So I hope that I could explain how all this works together. Of course, it has to be calculated for each individual vehicle, which we do on our vehicles, on our products. And of course, there's a difference between a man and a Mercedes. And it also depends on the size of the tire, because here we have 14-0 tires. If you have 16-0 tires, you cannot do that maximum steering angle because it's touching the steering linkage much sooner than with the smaller tires. There's a difference between turning circle to the left or to the right. So, but I principally wanted to explain what this all is about, and especially I want to point out that 6x6 versus 4x4, the 6x6 even has advantages. I hope you enjoyed the video, you liked it. If you like it, then please push the button, and you're also welcome to subscribe the channel. And thanks for watching, and see you on the next video. Bye-bye.